Anything sexual involving the word daddy is disgusting as fuck. I don't want my girlfriend calling me daddy. I'm supposed to be turned on by some incest fantasy? Disgusting. Nothing would deflate my dick quicker than a girl I'm about to have sex with calling me that. Same with Poppy or anything similar. This seems to be getting more and more popular on porn sites and in sexual stories and erotica. What the fuck is driving this huge influx of weirdos who want to pretend their significant other is their little girl? It's repulsive to me, and no, I don't want to say whatever floats your boat to the people who enjoy that shit. I don't want to hear or see it. Ever.
Can somebody please explain to me why the little girl act works on men?
But the long version or the short version?
Short version.
Short version. Who's your daddy?
Oh, you know, when you think about that, that phrase is really creepy.
No, it's not. It's fun. Here, watch this. Hey, Lily. Who's your daddy?
Not all spanking fetishists play with the word daddy, but many do. I have dozens of friends who are in DDLG relationships with their partners, so I'm used to hearing that word all the time. At this point in my life, it's totally normal to me. But there is this idea in pop culture, and even sometimes within our own community, that calling your partner daddy is weird. I know a few spanking fetishists who say they're squicked out by the term. Even I'm sorry to say, used to feel that way. As spankos, many of us have worked through, or are still working through, a whole mess of baggage about this fetish. A lot of us already spend enough time worrying that our sexualities are some kind of damaged response to childhood trauma as it is. And the last thing we need is yet another detail that seems to confirm daddy issues.
Okay, let me get this straight. So in this scenario, because you make such sweet love to Lily, she is now your daughter.
No, she is not my daughter. I'm just her daddy. Wow, that is disgusting.
But is that what's really going on here? What's the deal with daddy? Is this term, as the characters in this scene from How I Met Your Mother argue, creepy? Disgusting? Incestuous? To paraphrase my main squeeze, what's in a name? What's daddy? It is nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Is calling your partner daddy weird? To understand why calling your partner daddy isn't weird, and is, in fact, totally normal and has been for a long time, I want to dig into the history of the term, because calling a sexual or romantic partner daddy is nothing new. And like a lot of cool things in our culture, it mostly started with Black women and sex workers. According to the Random House Dictionary of American Slang, the oldest use of the term daddy to refer to someone other than a literal father dates back as far as 1681, when sex workers used the term to refer to pimps or to older male customers. A few centuries later, in the early 1900s, blues singers started using the term daddy to refer to lovers who took care of their financial needs.
At the clock, and the clock struck one. I said, now, daddy, ain't we got fun? He kept rocking.
How can I be your sweet mama when you're a daddy to somebody else?
So the etymology of daddy in sexual or romantic contexts probably works something like this. Sex workers repurposed the term from literal fathers to any older male who provided for their financial needs, and blues singers turned that into art. After that, daddy made the leap from Black working class music culture to everyone else around 1938, when it appeared on Broadway in Cole Porter's My Heart Belongs to Daddy.
While tearing off a game of golf, I may make a play for the caddy. But when I do, I don't follow through, 'cause my heart belongs to daddy.
That song is not about her literal father, okay? And then daddy was pretty much everywhere. In 1953, Marilyn Monroe's character in Gentlemen Prefer Blondes calls her wealthy fiance daddy a whole bunch of times.
Daddy, I bet you made me the happiest girl in the world.
In 1949, country legend Hank Williams sang, "Lord, I loved to hear her when she called me sweet daddy."
She'll do me, she'll do you, she's got the kind of loving. Lord, I love to hear her when she called me sweet daddy.
Again, he is not talking about his daughter. Later, in 1950's Moanin' in the Blues, Williams actually refers to himself as a daddy, demonstrating that not only had it become totally normal for women to refer to their partners as daddy, but it also had become normal for men to refer to themselves as such. And that's just what was going on in the English-speaking United States. I really don't have time to dig into the very rich history of Spanish-speaking people referring to lovers or romantic partners as papi or mamacita.
I love you, papi. I love you, papi. I love you, love you, love you, papi.
But suffice it to say, English is not the only language where these terms of endearment are not weird. Eventually, of course, the term daddy was embraced by sexual and gender minorities, most notably the leather daddy community and other branches of the BDSM tree. And that is where we find ourselves, Spankos. We're just hanging out on our branch of the tree, being no more weird than Bessie Smith, Cole Porter, Hank Williams, or Marilyn Monroe. But wait. Just because something has deep roots in history, that doesn't necessarily mean it's not weird. Like, if we have learned anything from cookbooks of the 1970s, it's that something can be both historic and super weird. So let's revisit the clip that started this all. In this episode of How I Met Your Mother, Lily argues that calling your partner daddy is weird because...
You know, when you think about that, that phrase is really creepy.
No, it's not. It's fun. Here, watch this. Hey, Lily. Who's your daddy?
Okay, let me get this straight. So in this scenario, because you make such sweet love to Lily, she is now your daughter.
No, she is not my daughter. I'm just her daddy. Wow, that is disgusting.
That's what these characters think. So let's hear them out. What do these characters think is a normal term of endearment for a sexual or romantic partner? What is the non-creepy word they use for each other?
Baby, no. Sorry, baby, I gotta work.
Good night, baby.
Baby, it was a mouse. Baby, please.
Baby.
Baby. Baby.
I love you, baby.
Okay, I think I get it. These characters call each other baby. That's not weird, right? That's totally normal. It's so normal that just a few months ago, President Obama used that term to wish his wife a happy birthday. But wait. If I interpret the term baby as literally as Lily wants to interpret the term daddy, a baby is a... If you think it's weird to call a sexual partner daddy, but you don't think it's weird to call a sexual partner baby, maybe ask yourself if your opinions are really your opinions, or if you're just sucking on social norms. Nobody notices it because calling a sexual or romantic partner baby is super normative, but come on guys, baby can also seem like a really creepy thing to call your partner if you want to worry about the literal meaning of the word. So don't worry about it. It is no more weird or creepy or incestuous or evidence of issues to call a partner daddy or mommy than it is to call a partner baby. These words aren't literal. They're totally normal terms of endearment with deep historical and cultural roots in both fetish and mainstream society. If DDLG or MDLB play isn't your kink, that's totally cool. But we in the fetish communities need to stop judging each other, just like we need to stop judging ourselves. I know that when I used to get squicked out by terms like daddy and mommy, it was just a manifestation of my own shame and self-loathing. I was scared. And there's nothing more unerotic than fear.
Hey, daddy.
Hey, baby.
Oh, that is disgusting.
What are we watching?
Nothing much.